We're told that there's a path that we're meant to take from the moment that you're born, that there's something that you're destined to do. However, life sometimes has a different role in mind. Growing up, I came from a humble beginning, from a middle-class Indian home in New Delhi. And, you know, life was normal, like any Indian girl would have. You go to school, you come back, you play with your siblings. And you know, just going about life like any little Indian girl would. At about the age of 12, 13, my parents decided to put us in an international school where my whole life view completely changed. I started noticing how, you know, different cultures and different people around the world lived, and it made me have a very international mindset and learn a lot about different cultures from all over the place. So after I finished high school, for my university, I moved to the Netherlands, to a completely different continent. And, you know, once again, having had crazy culture shocks and wow moments of how life could be lived in such different ways in just two different continents. And that made me grow into a person that had almost learned the best of both worlds. As I grow older, you know, I would realize that life was not as fair. When I would look around my house and my being and notice the things that I had, while if you look just outside your car window and look at how the majority of the country lived, you would realize that life is very unequal and unfair. And I think there was this spark that ignited in me at that young age to realize I had to do something about it and do something about this unfair and unjust society that we live in. Reaching into my inner humanitarian, when I had to decide what subject to study, I decided to take upon human rights law. And I think that was my way of really trying to study to see how I could give back to society, regardless of gender or class of a person. How could you leave this world a little bit better than you found it? So at the crossroads of my bachelor's and master's, I realized the beauty and importance of passion and how, you know, if you are passionate about something, you can really let that become your job and your profession and you wouldn't work a day in your life. At this moment before my master's, I realized that law ultimately was not my passion. And I found that passion within social media, and I found that you could still use social media in that same way, and I could still do the humanitarian work that I wanted to do with my law degree through social media. So when Instagram first came into my life, I decided to take it upon me, despite what people said about leaving law to become an Instagram influencer. But as life would have it, I realized that there was really global representation lacking for the Desi community. There was no girls that looked like me or that, you know, I could look up to online on social media. And so I decided to take that and make that my path to do that for Desi girls all over the world. 5 years down the line after starting on Instagram, I now have a community of almost 1.2 million followers. I've traveled the world and met the most incredible, talented people in the world. And if anyone would have told me this years ago, I would not have believed them. And I am so grateful for every opportunity that being on Instagram has given me, and I continue to do so until this day. So it all started in 2015. When my mother was my first investor, who gave me £200 to basically buy an outfit. I reused the £200 multiple times to buy multiple different outfits, take photos of it, and then return it. And over time, you know, people think that success just came so naturally, but it wasn't. Everyone forgets to notice that it takes so much time, a lot of rejection, a lot of no's, and picking yourself up every time to keep going. Today, I can proudly say that I've co-founded an NGO with my husband called Post for Change. When we noticed that social media was such a powerful tool in you know, garnering change, we realized that there needed to be a bridge where social media influencers could use their voices and platform for good. And that's when Post for Change decided to start partnering up with huge NGOs like UNICEF, UN Women, and the United Nations' Spotlight Initiative. Our first campaign with Post for Change was with UNICEF India, where we created the Red Dot Challenge, which was created to raise awareness for menstrual hygiene. And that campaign reached a staggering 110 million people. Today, Post for Change strives for women empowerment in all areas. We really work with incredible NGOs and incredible influencers to raise awareness for things like sexual rights and mental health and equality for women. Another thing that Instagram really made me aware of, and my journey online and offline made me realize, is that true beauty lays in imperfection. For the longest time, you know, on my own Instagram, I perfectly crafted every photo and made everything look amazingly perfect, but that was not reality. And I noticed the amount of girls that would get affected by that online. I wanted to really promote the idea of real over perfect, and that how you look in reality and how you are in real should be celebrated more than the perfect version of yourself. For me, social media is not just a fun hobby, it was my entire career. And to realize that, you know, you wanted to constantly share this perfect version of your life was affecting my mental health as well. And so we realized that sharing this unscripted, unedited version made life so much nicer for me, but also for my followers to realize that you are a human being after all. And so what can I leave you guys with? My golden rules in life would be: stay true to yourself, be persistent, and have a goal that is bigger than yourself to leave this world a little better than you found it. We are always put into categories by people of who we are meant to be, supposed to be, how we should act. But life is constantly changing. Change is the only constant in life. So my big advice would be: learn, unlearn, and relearn. Keep growing as a person. Thank you.